We are following in a couple of minutes, a couple of seconds I have to say, the very last and decisive game between Garry Kasparov and Nigel Short. Nigel Short has white pieces in the very last game. And I have to admit that all my prognosis after, again, I repeat it, after the fifth game were not correct, and by winning two games in a row, Nigel Short equaled the situation, the stand in the match, and now 3.5, 3.5. I remember, ladies and gentlemen, once the match, the tournament in Russia, when Vasily Smyslov became 75, and or 70, maybe 70, and Samuel Reshevsky from America came, and he played in the tournament, and he beat Smyslov twice. And when poor Smyslov asked his colleague, "Why, Sammy, you did such a thing with me?" Sammy said, "I have so terrible a score with you, Vasily, that I'm afraid it is the very last possibility to make it score a little bit better." And we can, following the eighth game of the match Kasparov Short, and we ask ourselves, maybe in the very last game, Nigel Short will try to make his score against Garry Kasparov a little bit better. Now they are ready to start. Not yet, but in a couple of seconds, I see that the both of them are on the table, and the referee must start the very last game. And well, speaking about back to the strategy of Nigel, actually he follows the openings of his idol Boris Spassky, who is unfortunately seriously ill and now in the hospital in Paris. He got a stroke one day, and he tries to recover. They started e4, e5, and e4, e5. And also very old opening. In this case, the two knights opening. Two knights opening, and knight g5, the variation of God knows also this position Paul Morphy played in New Orleans and also in Europe 200 years ago, something like that. Knight d5, knight f3. I have to say that there are new ideas in these openings developed last time, particularly by the American chess players, Nakamura, and the Russian chess players, Morozevich, and the others. Bishop d6, we can see that white is on pawn up, but black has two bishops, and the point of white on d3 is very weak, knight c3, and now, what it seems that both of them, this position, they play very quickly. However, it's very unusual position on the board. Maybe it's unusual only for me. Knight c3. Black's knight on a5 is also out of play. And sometimes white plays d3, d4. If black plays bishop g4, for instance, I can play h3, bishop h5, and then g4, and pawn on e5 is not protected. So it's a right time for black to make a decision of what to do, to play knight b7, to play bishop f5, because now knight takes e5, it's a threat, or d3, d4. So black played rook e8, and it's clear he protects his pawn on e5. And, well, he says, now it's your turn. what to do? D4. Well, now I can take on D4 and the king is very weak. D4 I don't like. Knight E4 and knight G3 maybe is idea. I don't know. I don't like. H3 is a move. Now white's turn to make a move, to make a plan, I dare say. Or H3. Well, the idea of the move is clear. He doesn't like the to be pinned by diagonal h5 d1 by bishop g4, and he prefers to play h3. C5. Well, the idea of the move is also clear. He likes to put his bishop on ground diagonal, bishop b7 or bishop a6, and d4 is not impossible to play for white, and to play b3, I don't know, b3, bishop a6, well, somehow I don't like white's position. I'm afraid white has to fight for equality, and so after 15 moves, bishop a3, bishop takes d3, knight e4, well, doesn't look so attractive. To protect the pawn from c2, then bishop f8 and pawn on d3 is still, or bishop c7 or whatever, and pawn is still hanging. I don't know. Bishop a3. Yeah. The idea of the move on bishop d3 to play rook c1 and then or knight e4 and to knight e4. He took on e4, f5. Dangerous position for rook a4 for white, because this king, I don't like this king so much. For instance, e4, he move, oh yes, he played e4, and I don't see so many pieces on king side, and if queen comes on h4 and then on f4 and then a rook comes on e6 and on g6, I don't like white's position. Knight h2. Rook c1, knight c6, rook c1. Very quiet and actually very, well, not panic. And I would be in panic in this position if I had white pieces against Kasparov, particularly against Kasparov. Rook c1, he plays against this pawn on c5. Queen e7 is a move, knight e5 is a move, and knight d3, knight e5. Well, it looks that black's position is tremendous. Black's position is tremendous. Knight d3 is threatening with win. Bishop takes c5, knight d3 off take on c5, and then knight d4. D4. That's a move. Now the idea of this move on knight d3 to sacrifice exchange somehow on c5, on c takes d4, take on d6 and rook takes d4, very clever move. And on e takes d3, it looks like the best move, maybe to take on c5. d4, it looks like a good move. Chapeau, d4, knight d3, Garry forced to sacrifice actually the exchange on c5. How? I don't know. Or pawn takes c5, or rook takes c5, or he took with the pawn on c5. Very interesting game. However, black is tremendous in this position. Bishop f4, bishop f4. He doesn't like, Garry, he doesn't like to take this exchange. He likes to play for attack here. And honestly speaking, now I see that white's position is critical. Queen comes to h4. On c1 is threatening, and I see that he is, well, the time is there equal, but I don't see a reasonable move for white. Rook, what comes on rook c2? Some of combinations, but which one? I don't see. Rook c2. Rook c2. Rook c2. Only move. Maybe I was too pessimistic about white's position. Maybe he black had to take on c1, e3. Well, I didn't see this idea, and it looks like decisive move, because of if I take on e3, then bishop takes e3 with immediately wing, and f3 is only move. But how to win this position with black? If you have only 1 minute, if you are 48, if you are very tired, and if you are still a genius, how to win? Bishop g3. Bishop g3. Well, he likes to put his knight on f4 and still play e2. Knight f1? No. Knight f1, yes. Bishop f2. But still, it's not... It's, of course, tremendous position for black. Knight f4. Now is e2 is threatening, and it's a combination, ladies and gentlemen. If I take on d1, or on d8, rook takes d8, and if I take on f4, e2, and I have to give here exchange on or even stronger, rook d1 with immediately winning. Rook d1, rook e2, bishop g3. Now is king g1, bishop takes f4, and we can make a conclusion that black is exchange up, and his position is completely winning, because yes, white has no moves. Bishop c5, rook d4, bishop a5, rook d5. Well, he's still alive. Bishop b4, a5, take on a5. What else? Then rook takes c5. And rook, if I take on a5, rook takes a5, and rook c1, and, well, it's only move. And now bishop is hanging, and rook c1 is threatening. What to do? Bishop b6, rook c1, bishop takes e3. Now black is rook up, and clearly winning position, because mate is also threatening here from all sides. And I think this is the very last game of the game, very last move of the game, and I think that Nigel will resign in this position. And not only because he has only 3 seconds, his position is hopeless. Well, exciting match, not without mistakes, but attractive, and the result of the match, 4.5, 3.5 for Garry Kasparov.